What's going on?
Not much.
Victoria is the apple of Larry's eye. Now, I gotta tell him that his little apple wants to swing from a pole.
I was chatting with Victoria this morning.
Oh, my little baby. She hasn't called me. I haven't heard from her in, like, weeks.
I mean, you
know. Got no time for me.
Apparently, no time for nothing. Her room's a mess. I see it on the camera.
Really?
Her bed isn't made. She had stuff in the corner. But I'm not concerned so much about that.
What?
I'm just concerned because she says to me that she wants to, take a new class at school. Pole dancing.
Pole dancing? She ain't doing pole dancing. What, are you kidding me? When you hold your baby girl in your arms and you're looking at her, you're not thinking to yourself, I hope someday my baby girl will be dancing on a pole. What, does she want to be a stripper?
Oh, no, she says you can compete.
I want to see where they have pole dancing competitions. That's done in gentlemen clubs. She ain't doing that crap.
His face went from, oh, you spoke to Victoria, how's my baby girl, to pole dancing. Roar!
She touches that pole, I'm pulling her out of school.
If he could rip every hair out of her head right now, he would.
Because she knows not to mess with me because I won't stand for this crap.
How are you gonna stop this?
I think we need to go up there.
Just like that, go up
there. Just like that.
I think you might be right about that. I guess a surprise sneak attack. Victoria is gonna be completely shocked, probably embarrassed that her parents are showing up at her school. Well, you know what? You bring a pole dancing, you bet your little hot pants that we're gonna come up and see what the hell's going on up there.
So get your bag, get your hairspray, whatever else you think you're gonna need for this trip, and let's go.
All right, let me get changed, because I don't think this is something I would surprise my daughter in. I hope we're making the right choice here by just showing up. I mean, I honestly don't know what...
What do you mean, what you hope we're making the right choice? What other choice is there? We gotta address this. My concern is, I mean, is Victoria really understanding where this might lead? If you were to put on your resume, yeah, I could pole dance. Where does that go from there? What's the next step?
I'm afraid of what I'm gonna see when I go there.
You think she's gonna have a pole in the middle of her apartment or something?
There better not be. Larry rushed me out of the house. He's got me all worked up over this pole dancing thing. I'm gonna need my energy to deal with Victoria. I'm getting nervous and I'm starving. That's all I know. So I'm making him stop at a diner so I can get a quick bite to eat.
Wanna sit at the counter? Yeah, why not? Come on.
Hun, why, this is not a good spot. I'm trying to...
It's good for me.
Trying to be healthy and everything else. You sit me right in front of these? Look at this. How do you resist something like this?
All Teresa talks about is food. What she can eat, what she can't eat. Just eat it already. What?
I don't know. I'm just nervous. I just want to go there already. You know what happens when I get nervous? Spirit's always there to calm me down. Thank God. So excuse me. I don't mean to interrupt your lunch, but my name is Teresa, and I'm a medium, which means that I'm able to connect with people that have crossed over. So what happened, there was a young male that stepped forward and he snapped his fingers at me and I saw the doves fly out of my hands. That's my symbol for that someone passed tragically, sudden and or unexpected.
Yeah, my cousin.
My name is Matt and I'm from West Haven, Connecticut. We were eating lunch and all of a sudden Teresa came up to me and started connecting with one of my deceased cousins.
Were you like a brother to him?
Yeah.
Because he says, I need to get to my brother. Do you understand that? He put me in a car. That's my symbol for it. Someone passed in a car accident.
Yeah. My cousin passed away in a car accident 3 months ago. His car lost control. He went across the road and head on.
He dropped his son off at daycare before he left.
Can I ask you this? How do you connect with baseball? Do you play sports with his son?
Yeah, he plays baseball.
Perfect. So that is something that you feel that he might not know about, correct?
Yeah.
And was that just his son's birthday or was
yeah.
it? Because he just handed primary color balloons and showed me you handing them to his son. So just know that he attended the birthday in spirit. He wants to thank you for the way that you look after his son. This is how I like spirit to acknowledge and to validate that their souls still are alive, that even though they're physically not here in the physical world, that they are still with us just in a different way.
I've never really believed in mediums because I always thought it was like scripted. And then she came into the Elm Banner today and started like telling me all these things, and it blew my mind.
I hope this brought you some peace.
Thank you.
After today, I believe in mediums.
Nice to meet you. I wish you all the best. I hope it didn't freak you out or interrupt your lunch. Have a good day. All right, now remember, just be calm. Don't be excited, and let's just hear her out with this.
Usually, my surprise visits get people excited. I'm not too sure if Victoria's gonna be excited. Hi, Victoria! Look at
Hi,
you!
Hi, Vay.
What the hell is going on? I mean, don't get me wrong, it's definitely nice to see my parents, but what are they doing here?
Why are you guys here?
Why are we here?
Because I told Daddy about our little chat the other day, and he is having a conniption.
So you decided to drive 2 hours
yes.
to come here to talk about pole dancing.
His idea.
Don't even say that word in front of me. Really, Victoria? When you tell your parents that you want to take pole dancing lessons, you really shouldn't be surprised when they show up at your front door.
Your apartment's very nice.
Thank you.
Actually, you keep it a lot nicer than you keep your bedroom at home.
I know.
So are you guys interested in this pole dancing competition?
Give it a shot.
Yeah, they brought it up before.
Whose idea was this?
Those two found it on the internet.
Those two.
Yeah.
These two.
Listen, if you were to tell me that you're becoming a firefighter and that's the pole you were gonna slide on, I'd have no problem with it.
I know what you're picturing in your head, like a strip club, and that's not that.
That's the only kind of pole dancing I know.
I can understand why my dad is so hung up about this pole dancing, but he needs to calm down. Like, I'm not gonna be a stripper. I just wanted to try it once or twice. What's the big deal?